Hello everyone. Let us do the analysis of today's newspaper, that is December 15, 2017. Firstly, it's an article titled Looking for Balance in Power. It's an article on the recent trilateral meeting among Russia, India and China. New Delhi hosted foreign ministers of Russia and China this week. The initiative is considered as a balancing act after the quadrilateral meeting among India, Japan, Australia and US. The quadrilateral meet sent not so good signals to China and Russia, so India thought of refurbishing it. Now let us look at the history of RIC grouping, that is Russia-India-China trilateral grouping. The proposal for RIC grouping had originally come from former Russian PM Primakov during his visit to India in 1998. Then India and China didn't show particular interest. Russia was interested to get back its lost stature after the end of Cold War, that is in 1991. The idea of a strategic triangle, that is the RIC triangle, took a tangible form only in 2002 when they met on the sidelines of United Nations General Assembly. All three had different expectations from this trilateral grouping then. Russia wanted its stature back, which it had lost after the 1991 collapse of USSR. China wanted to check US. In fact, Russia and China's relations grew because of the American policies towards them. Now, what was the position with respect to India then? India saw in the trilateral a mechanism to bring greater balance in the global order, as it believed that unipolar US-dominated world was not in the best interest of weaker countries. Also, every country realized the potential in political, economic, military and cultural areas, and hence they came together. Now let us look at what were the issues discussed in the recent meeting held. Issues of West Asia and North Africa were discussed. Numerous challenges in putting world economy back on the track was other issue. Concerns related to terrorism, transnational organized crime, illicit drug trafficking and food security were other issues. Now what are the issues affecting the grouping today? India's closeness with US reflected in the quadrilateral grouping is one issue which poses a big challenge to RIC. Today the variables of the grouping is determined by the rise of Chinese power. With the rise of China, Russia is dealing with it by cooperating with China, but India is dealing with it by cooperating with US, Japan and Australia. So this is another issue plaguing the grouping. Now what is the take of the article on such balancing acts of India? It says that today's world is a multipolar world and India needs to balance its relations with many countries, and India is right in doing so. Just as China engages with US on the one hand and with Russia on the other, India is quite capable of doing it. Let us place it in the syllabus. It can be placed in paper 2, India and the World. Dimension under it, multipolar world requires multilateral diplomacy. Discuss the statement in the context of India's initiatives with respect to quadrilateral and RIC, that is Russia-India-China trilateral grouping. Moving on to the next article of the day, that is, it is titled Weather Disaster Management After Oki. The cyclone Oki and the mismanagement over it has raised the questions about disaster management in India once again. Now the article says that there are three basic failings in the government's response to the cyclone. The cyclone warning was delayed. Second, the warning when it came was ineffective because it could not be conveyed to thousands of fisher folk who were already out at sea. Third, and once the cyclone struck, there was no warlike mobilization and action, which are the hallmarks of good disaster management. Now the article asks what happened to National Disaster Management Act 2005, National Policy on Disaster Management 2009, and the recent one, National Disaster Management Plan 2016. Now what needs to be done? The article says that the cyclone has already resulted in massive losses, so it needs at least a decent compensation. Placing it in the syllabus, it can be placed in paper 3, disaster management. The article talks of some acts and policies related to disaster management. So dimensions of it. Dimension 1, National Disaster Management Act 2005. Dimension 2, National Policy on Disaster Management 2009. Dimension 3, National Disaster Management Plan 2016. Moving on to the next issue, it's an editorial titled House Rules. The article is on the issue of Brexit. A draft bill barring Brexit has been adopted by the House of Commons and the executive headed by PM Theresa May has been given a stinging defeat. In essence, it establishes the sovereignty of the parliament, for which conservative rebels joined ranks with Labour and Liberal Democrat. The provision will ensure that legislators have a voice in finalizing the terms of the exit agreement. The issues whether parliamentary sovereignty trumps executive prerogative of exiting EU existed since June 2016 referendum. Government held that parliament had no take on it. A judicial challenge to the government's position was upheld by the Supreme Court. The reasoning behind it was that since domestic laws would be altered following Brexit, a parliamentary vote on initiating that process was mandatory. The editorial says that Brexit involves larger issues of residency status of millions of UK and EU citizens besides London's financial liabilities to the bloc. Hence, parliamentary vote was necessary. Now, the defeat on Wednesday is indeed a big victory for the opposition, and it also points at the bigger debate whether referendum for the Brexit can override the will of the legislature, that is the parliament. Now, let us place it in the syllabus. It can be placed in paper two, in two topics, India and the world, and comparison of Indian constitution with others. It's a unique issue which has linkages of both Indian polity and governance and international relations. Dimensions under it: Brexit, parliamentary sovereignty versus executive. Brexit, parliamentary sovereignty versus popular sovereignty, which is expressed through referendums. Moving on to the next issue, it's a news item. Kalvari submarine, a big step in defense preparedness, says PM. PM of India formally commissioned the first of 6 Scorpene diesel electric submarines into the Navy. This is Navy's first modern conventional submarine in almost 2 decades since INS Sindhu Shastra was procured from Russia in July 2000. A conventional submarine is a non-nuclear submarine. The project to construct 6 submarines is undertaken by Mazagon Dock Shipbuilders Limited with technology transfer from the Naval Group of France. The project is expected to be over by 2020. Now let us look at the importance of these submarines. They can undertake different missions including anti-surface warfare, anti-submarine warfare, intelligence gathering, mine laying and area surveillance. Let us place it in the syllabus. It can be placed in paper 3, science and tech, very specific topic, defense. Dimensions under it: submarines, their importance in defense. Dimension 2, scorpions and their importance, and link it with Make in India in defense. That's all for today. Please research on the dimensions. Thank you. Have a nice day.